Welcome back. It is my true pleasure to present our next guest. She is truly an icon in the world of contemporary jazz as a pianist and composer. Her beautiful melodies have captured a worldwide audience of fans for over 30 years. Let's meet the talented jazz artist Keiko Matsui, who shares a story of success and gives us a glimpse at her current projects in this exclusive interview.
I was born in Tokyo. My mom was a Japanese traditional dance teacher, which is, you know, a Nihon Buyo, which she wear kimono and dance. But I totally didn't show any interest towards that. So she gave up and she took me to piano lesson. And that was a classical piano. I never thought becoming a professional musician. But somehow from elementary school era, I started composing little tiny song, and it was like a writing diary. I went to Japan Women's University's junior high school, and at the same time I started taking more private lessons about composing and arranging. Since I started listening to different genre, like Ella Fitzgerald, Oscar Peterson, those jazz standards. And at the same time, I started composing my own style. But during those lesson era, I had opportunity to compose for Japanese serious movie. And when I met the director, while listening to him, I received melodies. And from the intro, whole melodies. Since then, I started receiving melodies. So instead of trying to write the song, I start receiving. That's the really changing point. So I really believe that my mission of this life is catching melody and putting into my album and delivering my music concert all over the world. My music has lots of emotion, so every experience what I received, that is reflecting. So even tough time or sad time, it's reflecting to your music, and those elements and those sensitivity and emotion touches us. My new album was a celebration of my 30th anniversary of US career. It's called Journey to the Heart. This title has double meaning. One meaning is journey to discover myself, and the other meaning is journey to my fans' heart. So this album has a sincerest gratitude in it. And this is also my first acoustic project, which is I invited musician from Cuba, Jimmy Brownlee on drums, and acoustic bass, Caritos del Puerto, and guitar player from Peru, and percussion player from Venezuela, and Brazilian guitar player. So it is a really organic and handmade kind of project. So I heard that I am the first Japanese who got number one Billboard Contemporary Jazz chart. I'm the performer, and in US there are lots of opportunity. I wanted to get back through the music, because I have been fortunate, because I'm healthy and traveling with music, and I have two girls. And as a woman too, when I heard about the breast cancer awareness, I lost my best friend from elementary school, and she passed away before 30 years old. And so I really know that early detection is important. So I made a special mini album and put the sentences over there. And also I speak up at the concert. So those things I felt really important, and also against hunger in Africa. And also 2 years ago, I started charity work for the children. First place was Lima, Peru. And I flew there and I did a charity concert, and also did three, four workshop, and with the kids, jazz band or some local community, I gathered all the kids and mom and aunt and everybody just come to the one place, and I explain about the music and led them to play keyboard and holding their hand, kids' hand, and they play. So this year I'm planning for Uruguay, Paraguay, Peru, Argentina, and Brazil. I believe that music has no borders. And the music is very interesting because every album, every song is like a reflection from my life and my thought. It's like a mirror. So I can see, I can feel what I was there. I realized that I have like infinite possibility, because I can write anything, and my fans are waiting for new melody and so grateful, and so such a fortunate thing. So then I encourage myself, and depends on the melody's direction, I create new music. I'd like my fans to remember me as Keiko's music touched to my soul and connect people on this earth. It'd be